What is going on, folks? It is Rigor Mortis. We are back with yet another video. I know it's been some time. I've been dealing with some things in real life, but we are back finally. And today, I wanted to kick this week off by talking about one of my favorite stocks. I know it's an all-time favorite on this channel. You guys love when I talk about this stock. That is Castor Maritime stock. The ticker symbol is CTRM. We know the deal when it comes to this stock. Everybody does. These guys are a dry bulk shipping company, and they've been in the game for not too long now. They're kind of an infant company as of right now, but we've been talking about them a lot on this channel due to the recent movements in late 2020, early 2021. And so somebody in the comments said, please never stop covering this stock. And I promise you, as long as I continue to have faith in CTRM, as long as I continue to have faith in their fundamentals and I like what they are doing, I will never stop covering this stock. Let's go ahead and talk about what's been going on with CTRM recently. We saw quite a bump Thursday, and I know the stock has been getting absolutely brutally murdered when it comes to the about the 1 month, even the 6 month chart. I mean, it's just been really bad for the stock. We're down 73%, and I want to tell you guys up front that I have not sold any of my shares. I've been trying to buy more depending on where the buying power is, but let's go ahead and talk about what's going on. They did have a vessel acquisition, and that's why I think it may have bumped up here about 16%. Topped off at around 50 cents, and since then it's just been kind of going up and down and up and down and up and down. If we look at the 1 day here, yeah, we started at around 48 cents, we're at 46 cents. Not a huge change there, but nonetheless, it is significant. Now, what I wanted to do for you guys today is not only talk about the price action and what I'm doing, I want to get into some of these articles. Here we have the title, Castor Maritime Stock Looks Like a Looks Good for a Rally After a Sharp Correction. And I also want to talk about what CTRM, Castor Maritime, has been doing in general in terms of their vessel acquisition. So if you're new around here, please go ahead, hit that subscribe button, join the family, throw a like on this video. Let's get it out to more people so we can grow the family even bigger. Comment down below. I know a lot of you guys are fans of CTRM. Let me know what you're doing with your shares down in the comment section below. And last but not least, folks, your boy's official. I have a Webull affiliate link in the description below. Please go ahead and use that link to sign up for Webull. Get yourself some free stocks. It really helps out the channel, and I really appreciate it. Let's go ahead and get into this article. Castor Maritime stock looks good for a rally after a sharp correction. Now, take this with a grain of salt. This is from Investor Place. And so, you know, one day they'll say that Castor Maritime looks good. The next day they'll say that it looks bad. So take this with a grain of salt. Exposure to Castor Maritime CTRM stock has been no less than a roller coaster ride for investors. Roller coaster is right. At the end of fiscal year 2020, the stock was trading at 19 cents. Holy crap. By the second week of February, the stock touched highs of $1.95. What good times it was for CTRM. A big correction has followed, and CTRM stock currently trades at 45 cents a share. I believe that the correction presents a good medium-term opportunity for investors. Again, grain of salt. It's important to understand the reason for the correction. An obvious reason is profit booking after the massive rally. Guys, if a stock goes from 19 cents to $1.95, people are going to take profits. Easy as that. That being said, recently, from late February or mid-February to until right now, our penny stocks have been doing increasingly worse. So I think that plays into it a little bit too. People are taking their money out of these growth stocks, out of these speculative penny stocks. They're putting them into more concrete, more value stocks that have not a crazy potential to grow, but they're more guaranteed. And it says here, which was partly speculative. Further, Castor Maritime has a long due equity dilution coming. The company finally raised $125 million through a direct offering. And I should mention that the direct offering was actually at 65 cents a share, so much higher than what we're trading at right now. While CTRM stock has declined, the fundraising positions the company for growth. Let's talk about the bullish triggers for the a fundamental perspective. A closer look at CTRM. Here it just goes through some of the potential growth that the stock could see based off of how the market for the dry bulk industry is going to grow. And it says here that the economy contracted by 3.5% last year, and the GDP growth is anticipated to be 5.5% in the current year, and the growth forecast is 4.2% for the year 2022. So the world economy, they're saying, is coming back to normalcy, and that could help CTRM really make a comeback. And it also says here the dry bulk shipping market is also expected to grow at a CAGR of 2.6% over the next 5 years. And by 2026, the industry size is expected to be $5.1 billion. Now, if we grow at that rate, obviously, and CTRM is able to continue to grow at that rate as well, we're looking at a potentially great stock. Now, according to the International Chamber of Shipping, the industry is responsible for 90% of world trade. Guys, think about that. 90% of world trade that goes on these types of dry bulk shipping industry companies are responsible for it. Even with relatively muted economic growth, the dry bulk industry is likely to report decent utilization. And that's what we've been talking about recently. Yes, CTRM was super hyped up towards the end of 2020, beginning of 2021. But even after all the hype dies down, which I think we're starting to see that a little bit, after all the hype dies down, after all the short-term investors start rolling out, I truly believe that this is going to be a good stock in terms of something that's able to diversify your portfolio quite a bit. And as the world economy starts to recover, as we start seeing trade start to recover, I think this stock may potentially do well. Fleet acquisition and revenue growth. This is CTRM's highlight here. We talk about it every single time I do a CTRM video. I always talk about fleet acquisition. So let's take a pause during this article here, and let's just go ahead and look at their fleet acquisitions recently. Since we've made our last video, so last time we covered this registered direct offering, 125 million. April 9th, Castor Maritime announces vessel acquisition. I keep calling it vehicle, vessel acquisition. April 14th, Castor Maritime Inc. Announces deliveries of MV Magic Twilight and MV Magic Thunder. These are two vessels that they had made an agreement on previously, and they got the delivery. Castor Maritime announces vessel acquisition. Castor Maritime announces vessel acquisition. Guys, what are they doing with the money that they are bringing in through these direct offerings? That's one of the most important things whenever I see a company is doing a registered direct offering. What are they doing with that money? It seems as if Castor Maritime is reinvesting that money into increasing their vessels and increasing their fleet number, which is something that I love to see when it comes to these companies. Like, yes, we talked about how CTRM isn't, I shouldn't call it an infant company, but there's a lot of companies that have been in the game for much longer than Castor Maritime. That being said, these guys are trying to play catch up a little bit now, and they're trying to increase their fleet so big that they can actually compete with some of these larger companies and grow their market cap. I love to see it. That's enough about that, because you guys know how much Castor Maritime really reinvests into these vessel acquisitions. Let's go ahead and continue on with the article. From a financial perspective, CTRM reported cash of $9.4 million as of December 2020. In January, the company announced $26 million in fundraising from equity offering, $15.3 million in debt financing. Additionally, the company raised $125 million this month. We talked about that already. Overall, the total liquidity buffer stands at around $175 million. With this, the company is positioned to pursue aggressive fleet acquisition. I love it. For year to date fiscal 2021, the company has already acquired 9 vessels. Guys, that is big. I'm pretty sure the next sentence is going to talk about something about how many vessels they had previously, perhaps. When all the vessels are delivered, the company will have a fleet of 15 vessels with a capacity of 1.4 million DWT. So it kind of talks about how many vessels they had previously. Guys, whenever these vessels this is just for 2021, right? Whenever they get these vessels, they're going to go to 15 vessels. So if we do some quick maths here, we do 15 minus, what was it, 9 vessels, presumptuously, we get 6 vessels. So they're more than doubling their fleet in such a small amount of time, just in 2021. And this company has been around for a lot longer, not a lot longer than that, but quite a bit longer than that. So they are just aggressively trying to get more vessels. I love to see it. It's also worth noting that the acquired vessels have been contracted for day rates that range from 18,000 to 25,000, assuming a day rate of 20,000 for one vessel and a capacity utilization of 75%. The annual revenue is likely $5.5 million. I like those numbers. For a fleet of 15 vessels, this would imply an annual revenue of $82.5 million once all acquired vessels are in operation. That doesn't go to say how many more vessels they are going to get. And if they continue to acquire more vessels over time, that number can definitely go up. The company is positioned for revenue in the range of $80 to $100 million. It's worth noting that for 2020, the company reported a revenue of $12.5 million. So we're expected to grow quite a bit if these numbers actually end up hashing out correctly. The above revenue estimate is likely once the entire fleet is operational. In other words, a strong top line bump up is likely in the fiscal year of 2022. This is likely to take CTRM stock higher. Guys, for the people that are wanting to be in and out of CTRM, this stock, personally, the way I talk about it, it's not really for you. I'm talking about it as to how this thing is expected to grow, not this year, but next year and the years following. And that's why I like this stock so much. Another point to note is that the current contracts are relatively short term, and there's an explanation for that. I'm sure they're going to explain it here. However, the industry does not offer long-term contracts. If the company's fleet does get a multi-year contracts, it will translate into clear revenue and cash flow visibly. I like it. I'm not going to read the concluding views here. You guys can go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and talk about the stock itself. This thing, as I said, has been getting killed, but that's okay. We already talked about a little bit about the price action, and I'm going to tell you guys what I'm doing personally. Sitting here at 46 cents, man, it's crazy because I told myself that I was going to buy when it hit below a dollar. I told myself I was going to buy it around 70 cents. Now we're below 50 cents, and I have to ask myself, do I want to continue to buy CTRM stock to bring my cost average down? Me personally, yes, I'm going to continue to buy into this stock because the fundamentals haven't changed. People are just starting to take profits, and I understand why people are doing that. But I truly believe that this is a good buying opportunity for my portfolio personally. So I'll continue to hold on to my shares and try to even add more shares to my portfolio. But that is just me personally. I want to hear your thoughts and opinions down in the comment section below. As always, folks, please hit that subscribe button. If you're new around here, throw a like on this video. Let's get it out to more people. I appreciate you watching to the end. Please comment down below about your thoughts. It's rigor mortis. I'm out of here. Peace.